Hello students, good morning. Now today we are going to start with a new topic, that is your typical components of an operating system. In your previous period we learned that is the functions of an operating system, functions of an OS. And OS, as I told you, what do you mean by OS? OS is a operating system. And today we are going to study that is a typical components of an operating system. That means, as I told you, what do you mean by OS? OS means the whole interface. That means each and every computer, laptop, or any other device, that is your mobile phone. Okay, we are having an OS, that is your operating system. And this, according to me, this laptop, this OS means your, I am having Windows 7. Okay, this is my Windows 7 interface. For mobile phone, I am having the OS, that is your Android OS. For iPhone users, you will be having the OS, that is your iOS. Okay, so today we are going to study three topics in components. Okay, in components it is divided into three components will be there. The first one is your device driver. What is device driver? Now device driver means, in computing, a device driver is a computer program that operates or controls a particular type of device that is attached to a computer. Drivers are hardware dependent and operating system specific. That means, in short, I can say the best example, suppose if we are trying to buy a printer, okay, even though if you are buying a new printer, okay, as you know that if you are buying a computer, with computer we used to get, normally we used to get keyboard and a mouse and a CPU monitor. That means in computer the whole things comes, okay, and if you are paying, automatically we will be getting the whole parts also, that is your keyboard, mouse, CPU, monitor, the whole four things we will be getting in a free means we are paying it. But in normal terms, when we are buying a computer, we used to get such things. But including that, so excluding that, do you think we are getting a printer also with computer when we are buying it? No, we have to buy it in a separate one. Okay, that means computer is another hardware. Computer is a different hardware. Okay, so when we are buying it, whenever we are buying, those who have bought a computer at home or in office also, you might have seen, those who have not seen, you have seen that with printer you will be getting a CD. Now what do you mean by CD? That means that particular CD is the main device or a driver which is installed in. Okay, that means the CD contains a driver which operates printer. Suppose if I'm buying a HP printer, okay, HP printer, if I'm trying to buy it, HP printer, now these are your printers. Okay, so with these printers we used to get CD. Okay, we used to get a CD along with it for installing a driver. Okay, now CD, HP printer, driver. Now you can see, in case if you are not getting it in a CD, okay, we can download from online also HP printer driver. Just type it, you can see official HP printer drivers and software download. Can you see this one? After clicking on it, I think internet is very slow. Now over here you have to write your product name. That means what kind of printer is this, then according to that I will be getting it. See, in each and every printer you can see, I hope whether you are able to view it or no, I don't know exactly, but see, this way, each and every printer will be having a code. That means a model name or a model code. See, this is your HP ENVV5549. This is your this printer's code. If I'm taking another printer, you can see this is your HP Dextech 2634. Okay, in this way we have to write our HP printer's code name. Okay, then click on submit. Suppose if I'm writing HP Office, HP. Now you can see over here detecting operating system Windows 7 32-bit. Okay, this is my computer's operating system and version. Now they are by clicking on download option, you can see in download option it is just 9 MB file. After downloading it, we have to install it, and this driver, whenever if driver is installed, and then only our printer will be working. Okay, for working if we want to get a working printer, it doesn't mean just we have to buy and attach your printer's cable to our laptop or a computer. Here stops our process. No, don't think that it is not like that. After buying a printer, we will be getting a CD which is always inside that particular printer only. In case if you are not getting it, or it has been misplaced, or it has been broken, still don't think that our printer is a waste one. We will be able to use, or we will be able to download that particular driver by going to HP. The same way many companies are there. Okay, many companies printer will be there. Just go to their website or just Google it, automatically you will be able to get a downloading file, and just download and install that, automatically you will be able to use this printer. Okay, and this now this is known as your device driver. In short, if I am saying that, what do you mean by device driver? Device driver is a particular software which allows the computer, allows that particular device to run in our computer, is known as device driver. Okay, again I'm repeating, device driver is a particular software which allows to run that particular device. Maybe it can be Bluetooth driver, printer's driver, or Nokia suit driver. Such kind of many drivers are there. If we are trying to download and install in your computer, then only we will be able to get the facility or the functions of that particular device. This is known as your device driver. Okay, and as I told you before, this device driver is totally dependent on the computer. Okay, these device drivers are hardware dependent on the operating system. That means until and unless if you are not installing that particular driver, we won't be able to use the function, or we will be able to not get the facility of that particular devices. Understood? This is known as your device driver. Now next topic is about you, what is kernel? Okay, this is the second component of your operating system, which is known as your kernel. Now kernel is a computer program. Okay, a kernel is a computer program that is a hard core of an operating system. Whenever a system starts, the kernel is in the first program that is loaded after the bootloader, because the kernel has to handle the rest of the system for the operating system. That means whenever we are trying to turn on the computer, you have seen, as I shown you in your last period, how a computer turns on. when we are turning on the computer, you can see a small loading symbol is there. Okay, and that process is known as a booting process. Okay, and that's why they are saying, instead of booting process, they are saying that after the boot loader, that means a booting process, during that booting process or after that booting process, automatically this kernel, that which is known as your, which is known as the hard core of that particular operating system, it starts working. Due to this, what happens, we will be able to do partitions. That is your partitions means when you can see, can you see C drive, D drive, E drive and F drive? Can you see? That means each and every drive we are having some space. You are in your C drive, I am having 100 GB. Over here I am getting 276 GB. Here also I am getting 276 GB. Here I am getting 277 GB. Now don't think that I am having four hard disk. I am not having four hard disk. Hard disk is a one single thing. Okay, I'm having just one hard disk installed in my computer. Okay, from that hard disk I have given partitions. Partitions means I've just given the small spaces to each and every things, okay, to be which has to be stored. It's just like your home. As you know that in home doesn't mean just a room. Okay, your house doesn't mean it's just a room. House means it will be including your dining room, your bedroom, okay, gallery, kitchen, washroom, such a whole thing. After combining the whole thing, then only it comes to your house. Then only we used to say it has an house. That means in the same way, it's just a memory, that is a hard disk, as normal. Okay, from that hard disk we used to give up partitions. Now partitions, why we are giving here, we used to give C drive, that is a Windows C. Can you see this C drive is specially used for your computer programs, that is your program files. You can see MS Word, what are softwares I used to install, that particular software's files are being saved in a C drive. Okay, and rest of the drives are just for my convenience. I'm trying to do partition it. Okay, over here you can see in my E drive many important related, that means your school related folders are being installed, or it has been saved in my E drive. If I want to save some personal files, that is your, if my personal files, what I will be doing, I will be saving it in an F drive. Okay, if I want some important softwares which has to be stored, so what I will be doing, I will be saving in a D drive. Say this is my particular software drive. See, each and new softwares, Office 2007, Open Office software, okay, PC Connect, Red Hat software, Ubuntu software, VM player, zip file software. That means each and every software, what I have done, I have partitioned it. Okay, it's just like a house only, or it's just like a cupboard. In cupboard also, what you used to do, used to keep your wardrobe. That means each and every level we are giving. Suppose if as a male, I used to keep my shirts in one section, t-shirts in second section. I used to keep my jeans in third section. Okay, I used to keep my formal pants in a fourth section. That means I used to give a partition, which allows me to easily take care of that particular things. In the same way, this partitions is being done by the computer, and after partitioning it, this the whole thing is controlled by the kernel. This whole thing is controlled by the kernel. This is known as your kernel. That means whenever we are trying to bootload it, bootload means when we are trying to booting the computer, automatically this kernel starts it, and till our computer stops, it will be working. According to mobile phone also, as you have seen, whenever we are trying to turn on mobile phone, okay, switch on your mobile phone, we have seen a lag will be there. That means some kind of lagging will be seen when we are trying to turn on your computer, sorry, mobile phone. What happens? Why these lags are coming? Why? Because many kinds of folders, files, as well as your mobile icons, your icons will be also presented. So many things should be developed, or it should be settled where it was. Okay, so it will be taking some amount or some time for getting that particular program or a particular icons or a folders to be settled. For settling that, this kernel plays an important role. That's why it is said that kernel is a computer program which is known as a heart and a core of an operating system. Okay, now third point, that is a third component of your operating system, that is your shell. Now what do you mean by shell? Shell means it's just like your operating system, which access, which gives an interference for an access to an operating system. That means shell can be of two types. Okay, shell can be of two types. That is, first one is your CLI. Just underline it and write in your textbook or a notebook also, full form of CLI, that is a command line interface. Second type of shell OS is your GUI, graphical user interface. Okay, these are two types of operating system which is generally used. Now what do you mean by CLI and GUI? CLI means that is a command line. See, can you see this thing? Can you see this? That means whatever we are going to do, we will be using our commands. Okay, and this command, this is known as, which this is just an example, this is not the actual CLI. Okay, in our after this, this is your fifth chapter. From your sixth chapter onwards, you will be using the Ubuntu. Now in Ubuntu, we will be using the CLI also. CLI is, that means suppose for making a folder in your computer, this is a GUI, that is a graphical user interface. This, the whole instruction, all of these things are, you can see these icons. Can you see these icons? Okay, that can you refresh it? For refreshing it, what we used to do, right click off your mouse and go to refresh button. For viewing your icons, large icons, you can see I have increased my icon size. Now in case if I want to decrease or medium size, I have decreased my size of an icon, small icons. Okay, so in this way you can view in your GUI, which is known as your graphical user interface. If you want to create a folder in GUI, what I will be doing, right click, go to new option and go to folder. Now you can see over here, can you see over here a new folder? That means if I'm writing a folder's name as ABCDE, okay, folder name has been created. Okay, this is my new folder. Now deleting it, for deleting it, what I will be doing, either right click and delete option. Yes, this is your GUI. Whereas in your CLI, we will be using the commands. That means we will be using in Ubuntu, in your next chapter onwards, I will be showing how to use this many commands. Okay, for in your GUI, the best example, that is your cat space file name. That means for creating a folder, what I have done, I have just right click new and folders have been selected. For creating a folder in your CLI, what I have to do, I don't need to use my mouse, I'll just use my mkdir codes, that is a mkdir space abcde. Now after giving enter, automatically a file or folder will be created. This is how you are creating folder in a CLI. okay, when we want to create a folder in a GUI, just right click on your mouse, go to new, and in new just click on folder. Okay, the same way, if you want to delete, if you want to remove that particular folder, rmdir, remove directory, that is a folder, and then space abcd, that is a abcd is your folder name. Okay, if suppose if I'm taking students, this is my folder, students names folder is there. I have to remove that particular students name folder. I will be using rmdir and student and particular names folder's name, and just give on enter button, automatically a folder, that particular folder will be deleted. In this way, commands are used in CLI, whereas for your GUI, we doesn't need an commands. Just use your mouse. That means mini user interface will be seen. This is known as your shell. Okay, so shell can be divided into two. That is your CLI as well as a GUI. Okay, CLI, the full form of CLI is your command line interface. And second one is your GUI. The full form of GUI is your graphical user interface. Okay, these are your three components of your operating system. Okay, again I'm repeating, it's just a revision. First one, the first component of your operating system is that device driver. Device driver, as I told you, it is a particular computer program that operates or controls particular type of devices that is attached to the computer. Next is your second component of your operating system is that your kernel. Kernel is that particular program which is known as a hardcore of your operating system. Whenever we are turning on the computer, automatically this kernel is also boots up. Okay, until when we are trying to shut down your computer, it will be working till then, and this is known as your kernel. And kernel function of the particular kernel is that it uses the disk management. The best example of your kernel is that disk management. Okay, all those applications or the programs which is functioning internally will be controlled by the kernel. Now next is your shell. Now shell is a interface, user interface for accessing an operating system, for operating this whole things. What we used to do, we will be using mouse click, that is for minimizing this folder or this file. What I am going to do, I am clicking on this minimize button, automatically the file has been minimized. If I want to close this file, what I will be doing, I will be clicking on close button. Okay, so the file will be closed according to GUI. Okay, as for CLI, what we have to do, we have to use the command prompt. By using the command prompt, so that means command prompt means some code we have to insert it. According to certain code, our computer will be functioning. This is known as your shell, and shell is divided into two. A shell can be either using CLI, which is known as your command line interface. Second one is your GUI, which is known as your graphical user interface. I hope today you understood your today's topic. Thank you, students.